What up, wise guys? It's your wise girl, Alicia, and today we're talking about abstinence and contraception. Hip, hip, hooray! It's birth control day! This is one of my absolute favorite topics to teach, so let's jump right in. The first thing you need to know about birth control is that there are three different kinds: behavioral, non-hormonal, and hormonal. Let's start with the behavioral method. Like it says in the name, this method of birth control is all about how you behave and act. The first method in this category is called abstinence. Abstinence simply means not doing or not participating in something. In the context of this lesson, abstinence means not participating in sexual activity. But people can also abstain from other behaviors like smoking or drinking. I don't wanna do this anymore. And when we talk about people choosing to abstain from sexual activity, it's important to understand that abstinence means different things to different people, which is why it's so important for partners to clearly communicate their feelings about boundaries and limits. Abstinence is the only form of birth control that can be 100% effective when used correctly and consistently to prevent unintended pregnancies and sexually transmitted infections. The next behavioral birth control method is called withdrawal, or the pull-out method. Run away! Run away! Run away! This is when someone with a penis removes themselves from their partner before ejaculation happens. This method requires the person with the penis to really know their body, because ejaculate can come out of the body at up to 25 miles per hour. That's as fast as a car going through your neighborhood, only it's coming out of a body. So it's not impossible, you just have to be really in tune with yourself. And like we said in the previous video, there can be sperm cells in that pre-ejaculate fluid. So it is possible for someone with a uterus to get pregnant from pre-ejaculate fluid even if their partner withdraws before ejaculation. It's also important to note that even though this can be used as a form of birth control, if no one is wearing a condom, partners can still be at risk for exposure to sexually transmitted infections. On to the next category! I'm like way too excited to talk about birth control. Our next category of contraception methods are the non-hormonal methods. These methods include condoms, dental dams, and the copper IUD. Let's start by talking about condoms! Way! The first thing to know about condoms is that there are two different kinds. There's the internal and the external. The external condom is probably the one you're most familiar with, and that's the one that goes on a penis. The internal condom, however, can be worn in a vagina or in an anus. When used consistently and correctly, condoms are 98% effective at preventing unintended pregnancies, and condoms are the only form of birth control that can also prevent the spread of some kinds of sexually transmitted infections. In the US, there are no age restrictions for buying condoms, and sales clerks cannot ask for ID if someone goes to purchase them. But there's lots of other places to order or pick up free condoms if you'd rather not spend any money. You could go to your local Planned Parenthood clinic or the local health department. You could also order them for free online at getcheckedomaha.com or myiacondoms.org. I'll leave a link in the description to those sites. The next non-hormonal birth control method is called the dental dam. Dental dams are used for oral sex only. They are used as a barrier between a mouth and an anus or a mouth and a vulva. The reason that these are used is because sexually transmitted infections can also infect the throat. And so if people are participating in unprotected oral sex, there can be the spread of sexually transmitted infections, because many sexually transmitted infections are spread through bodily fluids. It's really important to remember that dental dams are only to be used on oral sex on an anus or on a vulva, or the outside of a vagina. And the barrier method to use for oral sex on a penis is a flavored condom. Flavored condoms are only for oral sex and should never be used for penis-vagina sex, because the sugars that make up the flavors on the condoms can cause different sorts of infections inside of a vagina. So again, flavored condoms and dental dams are used for oral sex only. The last non-hormonal birth control method we'll go over today is the copper IUD. IUD stands for intrauterine device. This means that it's a device that sits in the uterus. These devices must be inserted by a doctor, and then the copper IUD can be in the body for up to 12 years. Now, this doesn't mean that someone needs to keep it in the body for 12 years, so if they wanted to take it out after 6 years, they could. But it can be in the body and working for up to 12 years. The way the copper IUD works is basically because copper kills sperm. So if sperm show up in the uterus, the copper gets rid of them. Also, this method is the only 100% effective emergency contraception method. So if the copper IUD is inserted into the uterus within 5 days after unprotected sex, the copper IUD will make sure that no fertilization or implantation has occurred. And this ensures that the person with the uterus is not pregnant. If you remember from the anatomy lesson, lots of things have to happen for a pregnancy to occur. So if someone accidentally had unprotected sex, like if their condom broke or if they missed their pill, they can have a copper IUD inserted within 5 days after that unprotected sex, and they can make sure that they're not pregnant. So, real quick, before we get into our final category of hormonal birth control methods, let's really quick go over what these hormones do in the body. Here we have the internal genitalia of someone born female. If this person takes hormonal birth control, these methods can do a couple different things to prevent pregnancy. The hormones can cause the ovaries that store the eggs to stop ovulating, meaning that they don't release eggs into the fallopian tube. They can also help keep the uterine lining really thin, just in case there's an egg released and it's fertilized, the egg won't have any place to attach and grow. Lastly, these methods can also build up the mucus on the cervix. This makes it harder for sperm cells to travel into the uterus. Now that we know how they work, let's see all the different types of hormonal birth control methods. We have the pill, the ring, the patch, the depot shot, the implant, another IUD, and two other kinds of emergency contraception. Let's quickly go through them. The most famous form of birth control, other than maybe the condom, is probably the pill. The pill has been around for a pretty long time, and it is 99% effective at preventing pregnancy, but only if used consistently and correctly. In order to do that, the pill has to be taken at the same time every day. But it can be really common to forget to take your pill or to miss a pill. So in reality, the pill is about 91% effective because of something we call human error. But that's why when someone is shopping for birth control methods, really see if they fit into your lifestyle. The other forms of birth control that are also lifestyle dependent are the ring, the patch, and the depot shot. The ring! No, it's not that horror movie.
They say if you watch that video, you die.
Yeah, that's a lot of baloney.
Or from Lord of the Rings.
Precious.
This ring is a device that sits inside of the vagina for 3 weeks, and then they take it out for 1 week so that they can have their period, and the hormones get absorbed through the vaginal wall. Next is the patch. This one kind of looks like those nicotine patches. For these, a new one is worn every week for 3 weeks and then taken off for 1 week so that they can have their period. All methods work differently for different people, and sometimes for this method, it can either be too sticky or not sticky enough. But mainly the biggest downside to these is that they only come in one skin tone, and we know that people come in all different shades. The last lifestyle-dependent hormonal birth control method is the depot shot. This requires someone to come into a doctor's office every 3 months to come get a shot of hormones. Most clinics tend to give a couple weeks window for you to come in and schedule your appointment, so you're not running to the last minute to get there. But if someone struggles to make appointments on time, maybe this option might not be the best fit. Again, it all comes down to whether or not you can fit it into your lifestyle. The two hormonal methods that are less dependent on doing something every day, every week, every month, every year, are the implant and the other IUD. The implant is a long-acting, reversible birth control method that goes in the arm. This can be in the body for up to 5 years, but just like the copper IUD, if someone wants it removed, after a couple years, they absolutely can. This method is really gaining in popularity among young people because once it's inserted, they don't have to worry about it on a daily basis like they do the pill. The next method is the hormonal IUD. Again, IUD stands for intrauterine device, so this device goes in the uterus just like the copper one. Biggest difference here is that this one only lasts for up to 7 years, and it works by releasing hormones into the body to prevent a pregnancy rather than the copper one that made sperm unable to function in the uterus. The final form of birth control methods that you need to know about are the emergency contraception pills. Emergency contraception, or EC, can be used up to 5 days after unprotected sex to ensure that the person with the uterus is not pregnant and that they get their next period. There are two types of pills for this. There's one called Plan B. This can be taken over the counter, without a prescription, and purchased at almost any pharmacy. The other is called Ella, and this one needs a doctor's prescription. Both of these pills work best if taken as soon as possible after unprotected sex. And again, the other emergency contraception that is 100% effective is the copper IUD. Again, emergency contraception is used if someone's original form of birth control didn't work for some reason. Like if a condom broke, or they missed their pill, or they forgot to use a condom altogether. While it's important for people with uteruses to understand their options when it comes to birth control, it's also important for people with penises to understand these methods too, to help prevent unintended pregnancy, be supportive partners or friends, and to understand which methods of birth control can help prevent the spread of sexually transmitted infections. All right, that's all the information I have for you today. I know it was a lot. So our question for today is, what's something new you learned today? Leave your answer down below.